美术。
Oh Allah, benefit me with what you taught me, and teach me what will benefit me, and provide me with beneficial knowledge. Amen.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome to the fourth in a series of episodes brought to you by Maysoor in conjunction with Al Madina students. In today's lesson, we're going to be looking at number one, the ismul ishara dhalika and the conditions for its use. Number two, al-huruf al-shamsiyya, also known as the solar letters or sun letters, versus al-huruf al-qamariyya, also referred to as the lunar letters or moon letters. And number three, examples of Hamzatul Wasl and rules relating to it. And finally, number four, examples of Hamzatul Qat'i and rules relating to it. When do we use Dhalika? In lesson three, we covered the rules pertaining to the use of the word Hatha, and we defined Hatha as an ismu isharatin lil mufradil mudhakkaril qareeb. Once again, we defined hatha as an ismu ishara lil mufrad, when referring to somebody or something singular, al mudhakkar masculine, al qareeb close or near. However, in this lesson, we're going to be looking at the word dhalika and the conditions for its use. Dhalika is an ism from the asma'ul ishara. It means that. For example, we can say dhalika kalbun, which means that is a dog. Or we can say ذلك ولد, which means that is a boy. In the two sentences below, ذلك is known as the اسم الإشارة. It means that, whilst كلب and ولد are known as the مشار إليه. It is the thing or the person being pointed to. Although ذَلِكَ is written like this, it is pronounced as though it were written like this. So we say ذَلِكَ. It would be incorrect to say ذَلِكَ, and sometimes you will see a small prolongation sign after the first letter. In order to use the word ذَلِكَ, three things must be true. Number one, the thing or the person you're speaking about has to be mufrad, singular. Number two, the thing or the person you're speaking about has to be mudhakkar, masculine. And number three, it has to be ba'id, far. So in defining the word ذلك, we can say ذلك is an اسم إشارة للمفرد المذكر البعيد. Once again, ذلك is an اسم إشارة للمفرد المذكر البعيد. Now, let's move on to الحروف الشمسية والحروف القمرية. The Arabic alphabet consists of 28 letters, and those letters fall under two categories. You have those letters which are considered to be from الحروف الشمسية, also referred to as the solar letters, or the sun letters, and you have those letters which are considered to be from الحروف القمرية, also known as the lunar letters or the moon letters. If we look at the following words, الرسول, which means the messenger, النبي, which means the prophet, الدنيا, which means the worldly life, we will see that they all begin with al, and then the letter that comes after that is a harf, a letter from الحروف الشمسية, the letters of شمسية. So when al is prefixed or added to the beginning of a word beginning with a حرف شمسية, a letter of شمسية, the lam is assimilated into the حرف شمسية, the letter of شمسية. Or we can say the lam is omitted in pronunciation only, but still remains visible in writing. So we say in this example, الرسول, and not الرسول. And likewise, in this example, we say النبي, and not النبي. And finally, in this example, we say الدنيا, and not الدنيا. Also, الشدة is placed above the first letter of the noun. However, on the other hand, if the first letter of the noun begins with a حرف, a letter from الحروف القمرية, the letters of قمرية, then the lam from the word al is pronounced clearly. So we can say الجنة, which means the paradise. Or we can say الفيل, which means the elephant. And likewise, we can say القرآن, which means the Quran. We can see in this example, the jean, the letter highlighted in yellow, is a harf, a letter from الحروف القمرية, the letters of قمرية. So when we pronounce this word, we pronounce the al clearly, and we do not assimilate the lam into the jean. So it would be incorrect to say الجنة. And similarly, in this example, the fa highlighted in yellow is a harf, a letter from الحروف القمرية, the letters of قمرية. We say الفيل, and it would be incorrect to say الفيل. And finally, in this example, the قاف is also a حرف, a letter from الحروف القمرية, the letters of قمرية. So when pronouncing this word, we say القرآن, and not القرآن.